My friend, it is great that we're getting a chance to talk to you here at Buonanotte. We're talking to Celebrity Restaurant here at 19 Mercer Street in Toronto, the home of Rudy Blair Entertainment Media. Glad to see you, my friend. How have things been going with you and the group?
Oh, it's so much fun. We're having a great time. We've been touring through the US, UK, Canada, and now gearing up for a big Christmas Caravan tour.
Yeah, well, I was just say this. Look, man, I mean, Juno Awards, all this traveling and stuff. Did you ever think that this was going to happen for you guys? And when you guys got together, when you had this band get together, did you think that things would work out the way it did?
Yeah, so 10 years ago when we got together, I mean, we were just improvising music. We were making it up off the top of our heads. I don't think we ever really imagined that we would be able to take it to this level. But what a treat to be able to play music and spread the joy throughout the world. It's really a trip.
Yeah, but you're taking it to another level here, my friend. A Christmas album. But 10 years, man, in the business, why was this the right time for you to finally put out a Christmas album?
Well, you don't want your first album to be a Christmas album. Then you're like the Christmas band or something. But we've had kind of a nice, long, winding tour through many different styles and genres and projects, including we did a project a few years ago where we were performing with full symphony orchestras and taking that across the country. And our latest CD with Anwar Khurshid, the Pakistani-Canadian sitar player, and bringing a whole world of South Asian music to our band. And now with the Christmas album, we get to bring the energy and drive of the music rhythms we love to play to the Christmas songs that people love to sing. So we're taking some songs and turning them on their heads, turning them into rumba flamenca tunes from southern Spain or gypsy jazz from eastern Europe, Arabic rhythms, Cuban rhythms, East Coast Celtic vibe. It's a lot of fun.
What's the album called, and why did you decide to take this sort of international concept with it?
It's called Christmas Caravan, available online at our website, sultansofstring.com, iTunes, and all the rest. And I think part of it was that I grew up with a Christmas tradition in our house, and I know that when you strip away all the commercialism of Christmas songs, you can find some real gems, you know. And So what we do is we take those incredible songs. Some of them are hundreds of years old, like Jesus Ahatonia, which is more popularly known in its English rewrite here on Carol, stripping them right back to the original song and then playing with it and seeing how we can breathe new life into it.
Now, I always found, because I've talked to other artists before when they've said, hey, I'm going to do a Christmas album, two of the toughest things. One, re-singing and making the classic songs their own, and two, trying to come up with new songs, Christmas songs. Did you guys have that approach in this album also?
We did both. We had some songs that we wrote from scratch, but we also took some songs that have been around for many years, but really tried to give it an innovative approach so that people would be able to say, yeah, I recognize that, but that's different and that's cool. And then, of course, another thing that we love to do as Sultans of String is to mix and match. So one of the songs called The Little Swallow, people know it more popularly as Carol of the Bells, and that's what it's called when it has lyrics. But before that, it was a traditional Ukrainian New Year's carol called Shtedrik, or The Little Swallow. No words to it. And we discovered that it had a really nice ability to blend with Spanish Bulerias original that we created called Al Vuelo. So we kind of mix and match, and we're going back and forth in the song, kind of a mashup idea.
I'm curious, when did you record this? Because usually for a Christmas album, you do it in the summertime, right?
That's the big joke among recording artists. It's like Christmas in July. But we've been recording this album now. It was 2 years in the making because we were really going after those top drawer special guests. And a lot of them take a lot of time to get through the various layers of management. So we've got Nick Yanofsky, Ruben Blades, Richard Bona, Patty Maloney from The Chieftains, Benoit Bourque from Bottine Souriante, Mary Fall from The October Project. I mean, the list just goes on and on. And it really was, yeah, an all-star cast. A whole, like, I could have just hired somebody to be a special guest artist liaison. I mean, it was a lot of work, but it was worth it because each of them bring a whole bunch of really interesting vibe and authenticity to each of their tracks.
Now, are you going to get a chance to tour this? Because with the holidays coming up, man, I think a lot of people would love to get a chance to see you guys perform some of this stuff. Any chance?
Yeah, absolutely. And we're doing them all as a sextet with a singer, which is going to be very new for people who know us as an instrumental band. But Rebecca Campbell is going to be touring with us. She's like the singer to the stars. She's toured with Alanis Morissette, Bruce Coburn, Jane Sibri. So we're going to be taking this through Peterborough, Ottawa, Kitchener, Toronto, London, Aurora, Sault Ste. Marie, North Bay, Elliott Lake, and through the prairies. So sultansofstring.com has our full calendar.
You know, I keep thinking to myself, I know we've talked about this before, man, do you realize that this album could be like something that's really traditional for family? Like for a lot of people, listen to a Bing Crosby album. For me growing up, it was the Jackson 5 album. This album, Sultans of Strings, could be part of somebody else's family tradition where when they hear you guys perform, they think of, you know, mom baking that Christmas cake or opening up that toy.
Well, that would be hilarious, and I'll be interested to hear if that actually happens. I mean, in our family, we had a Mario Lanza vinyl LP that we played in so much it came out like a slinky eventually. And yeah, there are those touchstones, and Christmas is something that you visit once a year, and hopefully we'll find a place in people's hearts.
All right, man. So how do we know about all this stuff? Like you kind of mentioned where to get the album, but if we want more information on the album, future albums, tours, everything else, website, social media, where do we go?
Yeah, sultansofstring.com, and we've got sultansofstring.com on our Facebook profile, Twitter, Instagram. You know, just plug it in, you'll find us.
Fantastic. Look, my friend, thank you so much. Happy holidays, Merry Christmas, and cannot wait to see what you guys plan on for 2018.
Yeah, thank you so much, and Merry Christmas.